Updating you now on the young boy covered in chemicals by his adopted father found last week along the side of I-95. Well, today, the head of DCF appointed a task force to look into the agency's handling of this case. Angela Rozier is live in our studio with continuing coverage. Angela.
Tiffany, DCF Secretary David Wilkins not only ordered a task force to look into the matter, but he also appointed an independent review committee to do the same thing.
It has been a week since this tragedy became public, and the pain and the shock has not begun to wear off on anyone in this department.
Officials with the Department of Children and Families plan to spend the next several weeks conducting a thorough investigation. They're still trying to determine if a caseworker dropped the ball after getting a call on their abuse hotline just days before the gruesome discovery. On February 10th, the caller talked about hearing reports of abuse happening inside a Southwest Dade home, reports about a 10-year-old twin brother and sister being tied up and placed in a bathroom. On February 14th, that boy and his stepfather, George Barahona, were found overcome with fumes inside this pickup truck along I-95 in West Palm Beach. His sister was later found dead inside the truck.
Second-guessing and finger-pointing are the inevitable human reactions when faced with tragedies that defy logic.
And that's why DCF is also calling for an independent review with three community activists leading the way. They are David Lawrence Jr., the former publisher of the Miami Herald, who worked on the Rilla Wilson case, the five-year-old girl who went missing, and Bobby Martinez, a child advocate, and Dr. Jim Sewell, who was the lead investigator in the seven-year-old Gabriel Myers case, the foster child who hanged himself. Secretary Wilkins says he expects his investigation will determine what went wrong, what went right, and what improvements need to be made. He also expects it to make a huge impact on his department.
I expect changes will occur in many of our processes based on this.
And DCF wants to make sure this investigation is made very public. They plan to release thousands of documents of this case on their website beginning today. They have asked members of the independent review team to report their findings to his office by March 11th. Live in the studio, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.